workshop. I hope that you are all, and I'm sure you're all, your teachers and want to pick it up and want to get some new ideas about professional development. And you are all ready to join in whenever we're going to do some exercises and team classes. I promise you they won't be very difficult. Okay, let me introduce myself. My name is Hannah Pomarozzo. As you, some of you already know me, and we've already met in several other areas of our lives. I'm a teacher of English, and I've been teaching for 18 years. And why I'm representing the British Council this time is because I think that the British Council helped me a lot in my own professional development. The courses they offer, the materials you can find online, and the different kinds of seminars I should be writing were all very important stepping stones in my professional life. And also, actually, British Council was the one which made things happen in my professional life. Some of you were part of my professional life, which is really nice to see that we keep meeting on and off. And I hope that it won't be just me who is giving lectures this afternoon, but you are ready to share your own experiences with us as well. So, why is it a bowl of cherries or a box of chocolate? What comes into your mind when you hear the word box of chocolate? Could you please describe the box of chocolate in your own words? Just say a word, whatever comes into your mind. It's sweet, okay.
Forrest Gump.
Pardon me?
Forrest Gump.
Forrest Gump, okay, wow. Right, we will come back to this. Right,
anyway.
Tasty.
Flavory.
Flavory.
Guilt.
Guilt. About
happiness.
Happiness.
Makes me happy.
Okay.
Makes variety.
Variety. Okay.
Temptation.
Oh, that guilt and temptation goes together somehow.
Do you never know what it will taste like, especially.
So it's a kind of mystery.
Mystery.
That's what you're
nice smell. Trying to nice smell.
It has a nice smell.
Mm-hmm.
But do you know what it is like before you taste it?
Sometimes you do if you know that box of chocolate. Sometimes you don't.
I'm just curious about chocolate.
So you're an expert. Okay. And what comes into your mind when we talk about a bowl of cherries?
Summer.
Summer. Especially because it's over.
Sour.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Fresh.
Let's imagine sweet cherries.
Fresh.
Freshness.
Juicy.
Okay.
My favorite fruits.
Your favorite fruit. Okay. Very good.
And stones.
Stones inside. So actually, you know what it is like inside as well. You have the view of, you have the idea of the cherry itself.
Mm-hmm.
You know its taste, that's what you mentioned. You know what it is like, you know what to expect, how many you have. Right? That's good. Okay. Do you remember Forrest Gump? What was the part in Forrest Gump of?
I think it was a line that, a quotation from his mom.
Yes.
Because she said, life is like a box of chocolates, you never know what you get. Mm-hmm. Something like that.
Okay, thank you. Sorry to say, but we have known each other for a long time, but I have to admit that I didn't tell her anything about deciding here before. Okay, so yes, box of chocolate. And actually, why I gave this title to my workshop was because first I started to think about how I could raise your attention and interest, and then the second thing was that somehow life metaphors came into my mind when I was thinking about my own profession. And I heard two life metaphors in the last couple of years of my life, which just I could remember for long term. One of them was the one which was mentioned, and the other one was an old tune from the 1930s, Life is like a bowl of cherries. It's sweet and you always know what's going on and what is there, so you just have to enjoy it and eat it and be happy about whatever you get. How can you relate it to teaching? I hope that we will answer this question together by the end of the workshop. Okay, so as I said, my expectation is not to give you a lecture on what professional development is about, but I would like you to take some time and think about your own life, where you are at the moment, what you would like to achieve in your lives, because sometimes we as teachers, professionals, haven't really got time to take those moments. And I think it's high time to do that, and we are here for doing it together. Okay, but before we go on, I've already introduced myself. What I'd like you to do is, I'd like you to turn to a partner and try something that is the same in your lives. Okay, something that is very similar in your, not only in your professional life, but it could be even in your private life. And I prepared a couple of questions as well. Okay, so how long have you worked in the teaching profession? What do you like best about your job? What's your favorite teaching website? What has helped you to learn and develop in your career? What are your career ambitions? Because you can ask these questions with others as well. These are just a couple of happening ones. Okay, so do you mind starting it? Okay, just turn to the closest person. You can do it in Greece as well. You have known each other for a long time? No, not really.
Last quote in a couple of seconds.
cherries in the kitchen. Anything interesting or unusual? So what were the things that you found common?
But after graduation, I'm from Poland, by the way. I started teaching in the secondary school, and I taught that 7 years when I went to university, and my partner, he's been teaching English for 7 years, so it's seven. And then the reason, I enjoyed teaching that, and we agreed on this, that we love to observe, I love to observe, and he still is in the process of doing it. How young people were transformed into young adults. And when you saw the when they were 15 or 16 coming to school, and then when they left, they were like 19. And you could see the progress, and you have your influence. I know that teachers have an enormous influence on young people, and very often negative, unfortunately. So I try to do my best to have this positive impact on them. Because we have an influence, I'm sure. It's just the problem for us to be positive.
Thank you very much. It's a coincidence, actually. Was there anybody else who found something very interesting in common?
We had her
find her. You were not the
assessors. Similar thoughts. And also we loved, both of us agreed that we loved that working with young people makes us feel and stay young at heart.
Okay. So that's why there are so many young faces. Anybody else who would like to add something to this? Thank you for mentioning progress. I think it's really important, but not only to see the progress, but to see how we could progress ourselves as teachers. And just let me share with you one of my own experiences. I have been teaching for 8 years, and I was a very happy teacher, and I really loved my students. My students loved me. I could have extra lessons, so I earned quite a lot of money as well. I had no kids, so I could spend time to prepare for my lessons. And after the first 8 years of teaching, I just realized, and I was very surprised when I realized that my students did very well at the language exam. And I was like, wow, was it me? What happened? How did I do that? And I think that was a very important moment of my life. And from that on, I always tried to find out how and what ways I could do it even better. And some people reached that point probably earlier, some of them later in life. But let's see how it goes. So how would you describe or characterize professional development if you had to find a definition for that? So I would say that it's a progress or process of what?
Constant learning.
Okay, good. When does professional development start? When do you think?
Self-criticism,
yes, is an important usually part of it.
Inner reflection. It starts from the moment you start working. Professional development should be ongoing.
Okay, yes, that's true. Okay, could you please turn to the people who have got the same colored papers with a quotation on their chairs and try to finish the sentence. Continuous professional development is the process of. Okay, and it aims at. Have you got the same color? Right? Have you got the same color? Okay. And you progress of and aims at. Okay, so continuous professional development is the progress of and process of, sorry, and it aims at.
You usually need several answers,
And there are some actually on your chairs. Yes. And what I'd like you to do is to read them and try to find out what, in one word maybe, what these barriers our teachers usually face. Okay, so could you read them, please?
No, you'd absolutely, no, you don't need courses to develop. You know, I mean, they're helpful, yeah, of course, but why can't you develop in a different way without courses?
So you don't need courses, and you don't need the opportunities, but you
they help,
but
of course, of course, I think they're
helpful. You actually should
develop yourself.
You develop yourself and search for the opportunities. That's what you were saying.
And it's everybody's responsibility. It's my life, so I take responsibility for that.
Any other opinions from the other side? No? The same? That's what you think? Yes?
Yes. We have a different one. Should I read?
Yes, please.
I'm keen to learn and develop, but where do I find the time? I'm too busy. Having more to do would just add to my stress, says this teacher. I think the best opposite, this is an overwhelmed teacher, because most of us are overwhelmed with the activities, but then we thought that maybe good organization would help, or reorganizing things would help the teacher continue professional development. So that would be the barrier and the solution.
Thank you very much. This is what you think would be the case in here as well? Mm-hmm. Okay, so there is a solution as well you offered to this teacher. Wonderful. Anybody else who had a different one? Any other ideas about it?
I'm quite a new teacher and I want to learn and develop, but I don't know where to start. I remember the feeling of this when I was very inexperienced because I started teaching at the age of 18. But I asked.
It wasn't long ago, was it?
It was 25 years ago. Okay. So I asked for the support of my colleagues who was much more experienced than me. But I have to admit that it's very idealistic to think that you always find that teacher who supports you with pleasure. So I think this is the barrier. So it's difficult to find a teacher who has by heart.
And encourages you.
Absolutely, yes. Because the old members sometimes don't like the newcomers with new ideas.
Do you agree?
You are all different kinds of teachers. You would be very happy to support the young ones,
yeah.
I'm sure. That's why you are here.
Yes.
You want to develop continuously. And
everybody also
thinks
that starting at the age of 18 is quite young to start teaching because you didn't have enough time to prepare yourself. I think it's not by chance that university finishes at 23. When you are 18, you are still between the transition from changing from adolescence to adulthood. Today it's even worse. So today a 30-year-old can be still a kid without any problems. And that's a huge change from the 1980s to the 2000s.
Thank you for sharing. Okay, so actually there are teachers who think that they have barriers because they are not open enough towards developing. There are some teachers who are inexperienced, that's what we were saying here. And there are some teachers who think that, if you read the one in the middle, who think that they don't need it at all. So what do you think about
it's scary.
Those kinds of teachers?
It's scary. Because you never know everything.
I think it's a misbelief, actually, that they have nothing to develop. Do you agree? Do you think?
It sends the wrong message. I mean, is this the message that the teacher is sending the students?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, wrong message. I totally agree with you. Okay. Yes, that's true. Can you relate yourself to any of these teachers? You said that you could relate yourself a couple of years ago to one of the teachers here. Let me show you the other one. You cannot relate to yourself to any of these. There's only one you mentioned. I can relate to the computer here, I think. Which one?
Could you say that? Myself is a completely winner.
Yes,
I'm a completely winner. So I don't know where to start, but I think it should be starting with
yes. That's what I was going to say. So that, you know, you are here, so it is a starting point, and I think this is a good way to approach your goals, which hopefully we'll know what they are soon. Right, so actually, we can probably all agree that there are so certain areas we, all of us, can still develop in. So, can you think of any professional behaviors, so-called behaviors, areas, in which teachers could be better at? A little help is there for you on your handout. And it's the first one, and the headings are missing. So what I'd like you to do is to read the descriptions of these behaviors and find out what the headings might be.
or areas in which teachers could be at different stages professionally.
Just enough to read them through, but let's see the first one. Plan individual lessons and a series of lessons that fulfill course objectives. Use appropriate methodology and meet learners' needs. What could it be?
Adaptive
teaching. Plan, there is plan. Plan. What area of the teaching profession?
Course management, curriculum, yes, curriculum, planning lessons, for example. Yes, okay. Planning lessons and courses, maybe. Okay. How about the next one? Is there anybody who's ready to read?
It's difficult for me to have classes.
Someone should probably manage the visibility by your understanding of the learning process, the specifics.
Yes. So what do you think the heading would be? Or the area?
Individual
group dynamics.
Class
management. Or understanding your learners, actually. Could be one. Okay. The next one, please. Is there anybody who's ready to read?
For us? Lessons that we see.
Responding to the needs of the learners.
So we should know our students and know their needs.
Yes.
And analyze them. And be a facilitator.
Needs analysis, that's what you said.
Needs analysis, yes.
Yeah, okay.
Be a facilitator.
Facilitating the class, managing the class. Okay. Right? Could you read it out, please? The next one.
Be able to assess learners' needs and progress and provide useful feedback to learners on their performance.
Okay, so we checked assessment
and feedback.
Assessment, evaluation,
feedback.
Mm-hmm.
Managing feedback.
Okay, good. Right, next one, please.
Okay,
thank
be
you.
Be able to use the English language correctly and clearly. Be able to analyze and describe aspects of the language and its use, and communicate this effectively to learners. I think it's about subject matter, basically.
Yes, you mean knowing the subject well
yes.
enough, your own subject. Okay, knowing English well enough to be able to teach that. Right, and the last one, please. Anybody who's the first?
Active and role development. So professional development.
Professional development itself. Mm-hmm. Yes, managing your own professional development, isn't it? So, okay, thank you. Right, so this is it. So that's what we came up with. Okay? Thank you. And I hope you are ready for a game. Right? So I'm going to show you a couple of words, but in a jumbled form. Okay, and jumbled letters you will see. And my question is that it's okay to develop professionally, but how? What tools should we use? Or what tools are there? Or what techniques can we find around ourselves? So a couple of
feedback. Well done.
English teachers. Well done, you did really well. Right, can you mention any more?
that comes into your mind?
Reflection.
Reflection, very good. In what ways can you develop as a teacher?
Peer evaluation. Pardon? Peer evaluation.
Peer evaluation.
Networking.
Networking.
Good. Attending courses, conferences,
workshops.
Workshops.
Writing certain journal magazines.
Okay. Writing, but before writing, probably
reading.
You would be reading quite a lot, right? Any others? Okay, I'm just showing you the boss. Keeping the teacher diary. Mm-hmm. Have you met the teacher diary before? Or a teacher journal before?
Here?
Okay. So this is one. And actually, you can find lots of very useful ideas about how you could develop yourselves. Any other event might be something new catching your eye. Classroom action research. Any ideas what it covers? So research that actually is carried out within the classroom. So you have certain ideas about what you want to research on, and it takes place in the classroom itself. Right. I don't think there are any other ones which we haven't mentioned yet. So these are the ones. Right, so these are the tools and techniques you can choose from, and there are several others, I'm sure, and you are open enough to find these opportunities. But first of all, before anybody starts his or her development, I think we should be aware of what stage are you at. There are certain stages, and hopefully we all agree, there are certain stages of professional development, and let me just show you the ones I'm thinking of. The starting one, and on your handout, you can find a description of that as well. You are a trainee teacher of English, taking initial training, or you are not qualified as an English teacher, but working as one. Still exists, yes. Okay. So you can just think about yourself and try to relate your own professional stage to one of these. Newly qualified is the one that you are a qualified teacher of English in your first 2 years of practice, who is putting initial training into practice. Developing one, you are a practicing qualified teacher of English with more than 2 years of experience and still want to consolidate your essential skills. Right? Proficient one is the one who is an experienced qualified teacher of English with strong overall knowledge and competence as a teacher. Advanced one, you are a highly experienced qualified teacher of English who comfortably takes on leading roles such as mentoring and maybe planning to develop more specialist skills. And specialist one, you are a practicing specialist such as a teacher trainer, materials writer, syllabus and curriculum developer, head of department, manager, testing expert, advisor on ELT issues, or researcher. There might be someone who takes all these roles, and I think that that's a real expert and a real specialist. Right, could you think about yourself? And I don't feel comfortable about asking who is where, but you can just read it for yourself, okay? So, I would like to show you almost the last slide. So once you actually have already decided on your stage, what is the next step when someone should specify?
the goals themselves, the goals, and you have to decide on what you want to be in. And you have to relate the tools and the techniques to the goals and decide on when you will start working on your goals. Okay, so that should be the steps ahead. And I'd like to say thank you to you, and I'd like you not to forget Lao Tzu's message, saying the journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single step. So I think that the single steps could be these conferences as well, these courses, when you meet teachers, when you discuss things with your colleagues. And I wish you all luck in your careers. And I know that all the teachers need not only continuous professional development, but continuous encouragement as well. So what I thought that we should find out what the box of chocolate represents, finally, or the bowl of cherries, and if we can't, then I'm telling you my vision. And I brought you a box of chocolate as an extra, and be encouraging for your future. Okay, so what do you think the box of chocolate would represent? So how could we relate it to teaching or professional development? Box of chocolate or bowl of cherries?
Stages?
Stages?
Of your development, perhaps. I don't
okay.
know. Like,
so what would be the box of chocolate then?
No, no, that's it. Sorry, that was the box of chocolate.
Oh, that these are the stages.
Yeah, each different chocolate is a new stage.
Uh-huh, uh-huh. Yeah, it's very similar to what I thought of. So. Thank you. Oh. Bowl of cherries. So my version would be that the box of cherries would represent something that how I felt when I was. Young beginner teacher, and I thought of all the different kind of challenges, the class, the activities we did, as if it was a box of chocolate. So I didn't know the taste of it, I didn't know what it would be. I loved it, I liked it very much, and I was ready to try everything out. While now, as a probably more experienced teacher, I look at my profession, my job, my different kinds of the activities in life I have to fulfill as a bowl of cherries. I know what it tastes like, I know how much it is, and I think that sometimes I would love to taste a box of chocolate still. So it's time to taste the box of chocolate. So thank you very much for coming. If you have any questions, I'm very happy to answer. Or you can also if I'm interested. Anybody like to ask anything? Ready for a box of chocolate, aren't you? I wrote to Mirka because I have a very good friend who whenever I was very disappointed in my teaching career, she always told me, and it's a saying among us, that you deserve more than a box of milk or a bar of milk. You know? So I think it has an extra meaning, and I just thought that I would share it with you. So keep this in your mind, please. You deserve more than a box of chocolate.
Well, I think that you had a lovely presentation and you deserve it.